professional dancer. I did a foundation course in dance and then I did a degree. And I've always loved expressing myself. Expression with our body is like, I think it's one of the best things we can do. I think if you can move, then you can dance. And putting it with music is even better. I didn't start training to dance until I was a lot older than most people. Lots of people kind of start dancing when they're a little kids at like 3 years old. Mine was a bit later. And I just took a real liking to my dance teacher, and she really nurtured us. She was really, really expressive, really kind of happy and encouraging. And she saw the potential in me, so she kind of picked me out and really like cheered me on. I think a lot of my love for dance comes from the idea that we can become something else, we can become something different, whether that be a character in a story, or an emotion, a feeling, make our body express different technicalities, pick up parts from the music. We're becoming kind of something else, and it's really exciting. I love working in groups, I love working with people. I think one of the great things about dance is that you become part of a company. Whether you're teaching, whether you're a student, you're working with people, you're working with physical bodies and moving around. Of course, over COVID and the current situation, it's been really difficult to have that kind of bodily contact and partnership in the art. So I really, really love choreography. I love creating movement. I love listening to the music and seeing what I can hear in the music and bring out of the music as well. One of my favorite things is becoming a character and telling a story. I think our bodies are made to communicate, whether that's something good, something bad, but what we communicate is always helpful because we are communicating through our body. So when I choreograph movement, I always look to tell a story. I always look, what am I trying to get the audience to feel? I also teach kids. Over lockdown, it's been very, very difficult to do what I love. Normally I travel to primary schools and do classes and workshops for kids, but over lockdown, I haven't been able to do that. So instead, I kind of started a little Facebook page and was doing online workshops for kids, kind of Disney themed, fun themed, just really kind of fun and giving kids something to do in the lockdown.
Movie online dance class. We are going to start just around 4 o'clock, a little bit after, and we'll wait for some people to get on. Very exciting. These videos are going to stay, I'm going to save them, put them online.
I love their creativity, I love their enthusiasm. And their lack of fear as well. So I love teaching kids. And when I started this thing on Facebook, lots of kind of mums and families with kids were attracted to the idea. So I kind of did some Disney themed classes and things like that. And then from there, I now have some students which I now teach over Zoom. Hopefully, when everything clears up, I'll be able to teach them face to face. I've really made some good friendships through that as well. When I was in my late teens, I got an eating disorder and it became quite severe. It started off as kind of restriction and it turned into severe anorexia, which ended up with me going to hospital. I was very, very, very weak. I basically lost a lot of weight and what I saw in my mind was not what you could see in real life. I thought that I was really ugly, really fat, and dance was almost my way to control this. And I used dance to almost try and like keep the weight off, and it would be my way of kind of punishing myself. And all the enjoyment that I originally had from dance, I lost because I used it to kind of fuel the eating disorder. I didn't dance for ages. When I didn't dance, I actually lost my love for dance. So it kind of, I was stuck in this pit of not liking dance at all, but not wanting to get better. Then through a bit of therapy and prayer and lots of help, I was eventually able to start moving again, in little chunks. But when dance was then given back to me, it was like someone was giving me this new gift of movement and creativity. So what was once used for pain and suffering, and using dance as a really harsh thing, just a reason to lose lots of weight, was then turned into something beautiful. So now dancing is just great for overall mental health. Music, if we can keep music alive, then we can keep our souls alive. Music's great, and moving to music is even better. Moving with people to music is like amazing. So I'm really excited for when the virus passes and we can all kind of move together. And yeah, I'm really excited about that.